welcome, welcome. So, first of all, welcome. Glad you guys are here. Today is pretty neat because we don't get a chance to see a lot of these exams. And this particular exam, at fourth degree adult black belt, is a little different than all the other exams. So if you're a younger student, or even if you're a black belt, usually we tell you what to do at each level. You gotta know this, and then you perform this, and then you get that, which of course is a new belt. But at black belt level, every degree is a little bit more challenging. Junior black belt, you don't have to break. Adult black belt, you start doing the breaking. Second degree is a really physical test. There's a lot of demands and also challenges at each level. When you test for third degree, it's the first level where you are required to do a demonstration as your exam. And when you test for fourth degree, there's a lot of different tracks that you can choose. There's a physical track, there's an all cognitive track, and then there's a hybrid of both. And Wesley has chosen the hybrid, right? So it's physical, there's cognitive, there's mentoring students, there's a lot of things that are going on behind the scenes that you guys are not able to see today. But one of the requirements of that particular exam is to do a demonstration. So the neat part is we get a chance to see Wesley, or Sensei Blubaugh, at his peak performance, third or fourth degree black belt exam, which is a demonstration. It's gonna be amazing to see today, and you guys are gonna be glad that you took your time to be here. It's not gonna be a long test, and I say test again in air quotes because it's a demo. So there's really no way that Wesley can possibly not do well today, because he selected all of what you're about to see, which makes it very unique. It's also really challenging too, especially with somebody like him that's extremely talented. I mean, what can he do? Can he do sparring? Can he do breaking? Is he gonna do self-defense? He's gonna do all the weapons that he knows. I mean, if you look at his left pant leg, he knows them all. So it's really cool because he gets a chance to not only demonstrate his skill and his expertise, but he also has to hone that in a 30-minute demonstration. And it is a demonstration, so we're gonna be glad that you're here to see it. So feel free to take pictures, just probably not flash, but the video, is that okay for you? Photos? I don't really know what he's gonna do, but I did see him bring in a load of concrete this morning, so. No fire, though, right? No fire. Mr. Wood.
Fire bad.
Fire bad. No wood. No fire and no wood. Okay, anyway. So without further ado, I want to introduce to you, and I know you guys know him, Sensei Blubaugh. So whenever you're ready, sir, we're excited to see you. Yeah.
Welcome to Sensei Wesley Blubaugh's fourth degree black belt demonstration. My name is Jessica Tran, and Wesley has asked me to discuss his martial arts journey and his future goals. Wesley first started martial arts at Kickmasters on November 16th, 2012, at 11 years old. 3.5 years of hard work later, Wesley earned his first degree junior black belt on April 28th, 2016. And has continued to work hard each year to test whenever he possibly could. Wesley later earned his second degree junior and first degree adult in 2017, his second degree adult in 2018, and his third degree adult in 2020. Due to COVID-19 restrictions, Wesley completed his third degree demonstration in March of 2021. There are three different tracks one can take in order to earn their fourth degree black belt. The track Wesley chose involves creating a demonstration similar to third degree and writing a 25-page thesis paper on the topic of his choosing. His paper will be discussed later on in the demo. For his demonstration, Wesley will perform 5 katas that he has learned over the past 2.5 years, as well as complete several board and concrete breaks. If successful tonight, Wesley will be one of the youngest to earn their fourth degree black belt at KMK. The first kata Wesley will perform is done with the tanfa. Originally, the tanfa was used as the handle of a millstone tool to prepare grains. It can be used for blocks and strikes with 3 different grips. The 2 main grips are hantimochi, natural grip, and yakutemochi, reverse grip. The natural grip allows protection for the forearm while providing reinforcement for punches and elbows. The tanfa can swing out into the reverse grip for various strikes and thrusts. The third uncommon grip is tokusho mochi, which is flipped so it is grabbed by the shaft. This allows the handle to be used as a hook in combat.
You can count the dragons that have slain. You can give it all you got. Cause love is running through my veins. All this light can't be tamed. There's fire in my blood.
Weapon with both hands equally. After completing the main seven weapons in the current weaponry curriculum, Wesley has helped with the majority of beginner weaponry classes to help teach newer students the basics of the art. The next kata Wesley will perform is with the Sai. Just like Tanfa, Sai are typically used in pairs. In Okinawa, the Sai was used by domestic police to arrest criminals and for crowd control. There are two main grips: Hante Nigiri and Yakate Nigiri. The Kushira, or head of the Sai, is used for punch strikes while having the Shinbo, or shaft, protect the forearm from strikes. The Yokute can be used to trap and lock an attacker's blade. The Jute, which is a variation of the Sai, is commonly referred to as the sword breaker.
Thank you.
Wesley's third degree demonstration back in 2021, any of the open hand katas were that of the International Taekwondo Federation, which is where all of Kickmaster's katas originate from. For this demonstration, Wesley wanted to do something completely different. Over the past few years, he has been putting himself out of his comfort zone to try new things. In January of 2021, Wesley started training in a completely different style of martial arts. Kali, under the training of Grandmaster Anthony Hockley from Adelaide, Australia. He recently earned his red black belt this past June and plans to test for his Kali black belt soon. For the next two katas, Wesley will be performing Shotokan, a karate style developed by Gichin Funakoshi. Those familiar with the katas we do at Kickmasters will notice a major difference between the two Shotokan katas Wesley will do today compared to the typical ITF katas. The first will be kata Unsu, which translates to cloud hands, and consists of 48 moves. Unsu is derived from the constant transformations, expansions, contractions, and shifting of the body as his kata is performed, just as clouds constantly change and transform. It contains many intricate hand techniques, such as the one finger strike in the opening sequence. It also contains a 360-degree spinning double kick with a double leg takedown at the same time, landing on the floor face down before continuing. Because of this technique, it's a very common kata in tournaments testing the competitor's knowledge, spirit, and skill, which is how Wesley first came to know this kata. It took him about 3 weeks to learn this kata, and he has spent the last 2 years practicing and analyzing the details in every move to perfect them. Vincent van Gogh once said, "What would life be if we had no courage to attempt anything?" During his first and second years of college in the midst of the pandemic. The second Shotokan kata Wesley will perform is Gankaku, which can translate to crane on a rock, referring to the crane stance when one must stick on one leg as if a crane perched, ready to strike. There are 42 movements, and although the kata has many fast movements, it also exhibits many slow postures, lending a certain calmness to the kata. The practice of Gankaku helps to develop and requires excellent balance from the practitioner due to the crane stances throughout the kata and the one-footed pivot near the end. A quote by the author, Roy T. Bennett, "Your hardest times often lead to the greatest moments of your life. Keep going. Tough situations build strong people in the end." Multiple classes throughout the week, including self-defense, striking, and sparring. One of his favorite classes to teach is self-defense because he enjoys showing brown belts various ground grappling techniques to help first cue brown belts add a creative side to their self-defense demonstrations to better prepare them for black belt level. Wesley also teaches many private lessons varying from all ranks and all age groups, white belts to brown belts, children to adults. He is extremely detailed while working one-on-one with students and will think of multiple drills to enhance the skills of his students. If you look at the side of any black belt's belt, you will notice silver tally marks, or tiger stripes, as some students call them. These represent the black belt instructor's title, ranging from assistant instructor to senior master instructor. Wesley is currently a master instructor with 5 slash marks. In order to earn most of these titles, black belts are required to go through months of training through the instructor training program, which is led by the IT's instructor trainers. Wesley has been responsible for the creation of the head instructor and senior instructor training and leads multiple training sessions throughout the year for new black belts. As I mentioned earlier, Wesley was required to write a 25-page paper on any topic of his choosing related to martial arts. Since he is so passionate about teaching and heads up the instructor training program, it only felt appropriate to write a paper about the 30-plus teaching concepts he has been teaching to others for the past 3 years. In his paper, he defines each concept while discussing its importance and how he personally applies it to his day-to-day teaching. The last kata Wesley will be performing will involve the Chinese hook swords, also known as the tiger hook swords. There are five main components of the hook swords. One, the back, which is typically used like a standard sword. Two, the hook, which is used could be used to trip enemies or catch weapons. Three, the end of the hilt, which is sharpened and can be used for stabbing strikes. Four, the crescent guard, used for blocking and slashing. And five, the link, which is where the wielder connects the swords together and swings the one sword to extend their reach by 3 to 6 feet. The hilt on the sword that is in the air would be striking the target. A quote by Steven Spielberg, "The delicate balance of mentoring someone is not creating them in your own image, but giving them the opportunity to create themselves." To allow the person to exert the maximum amount of force. However, the higher the board, the more difficult it is to break. This is because there is not much space for the foot to follow through after the board is broken. While one board at waist level can be done easily by someone of Wesley's size, one board at a much higher height is more difficult. After the head level breaks, Wesley will do a single board break combo with a jump double snap kick, which is similar to a split kick. And to finish his demonstration, Wesley will do two concrete breaks, two cinder caps with a low line side kick, and six cinder caps spaced with a heel stomp.
come back to you.
Special thanks to the Master's Council for approving his advancement to fourth degree adult black belt, to all of his friends for the endless amount of support, to each one of his students that came to watch his advancement, and to me, Jessica Tran, who has stuck by his side since day one, who has been there for him through thick and thin, and is just simply an amazing, intelligent, trustworthy, ambitious, honest, funny, kind, patient, caring, fabulous, and humble human being. And these are his words, not mine.
Not mine.
Those are her words, not mine.
Well, anyway, he requests that all of the black belts stay afterward for a group photo first, and he will stay for any individual photos after the group photo. If you have not done so yet, please be sure to sign Wesley's guest book located on the gray tables by the main doors, and please leave a kind message to congratulate him on his new achievement. At this point, I will pass it back to Master Mando for the presentation of Frank.
I know he's out of here, but we should give him a hand, right? You were truly the star of the show, though. I mean, he was good, but without you, the whole thing just falls flat.
I know, that's what I've been telling him.
I don't know.
This whole time.
Is he paying you pretty well? I'm assuming.
No, he's not paying me anything. You, like, negotiate.
I'll talk to him. You know, the cool part about Wesley is he's very unassuming. You know, if you've met him, he just has this personality that is just very matter-of-fact. And some people either love people like that or hate people like that. Wesley just has this endearing quality where you just gotta love the guy. You really do. I was telling a friend of mine in from Michigan that Wesley's probably the best kicker here in the building, probably that we've never had, or one of the best that we've ever had, right, Sensei O'Connor? And we've been around for a long time, 30-plus years of just seeing excellent martial artists, but Wesley just always seems to take it to the next level. To give you an idea, the two cinder caps stacked is extremely hard. The jump double snap kick at the same time, I've only ever seen that done by the Korean National Taekwondo demo team. I've never seen anybody do that. No, not in this building, at least. And six spaced is no joke. That's the real deal. And the side kick that he did, you did with your right leg, right?
Yes, sir.
Correct? That's your non-dominant leg.
Yes, sir.
So basically that means that Wesley could hurt you in a multitude of ways. So you want to always be nice to Wesley. Again, I can't say enough great things about him. And I think the ultimate form of flattery is when somebody speaks on your behalf and says how great you are, instead of raising your hand and say, hey, look at me, I want to tell you how great I am. But Wesley was absolutely instrumental, especially lately, of putting together our instructors' requirements and also facilitating all the instructor training that so many of you guys have been through. Also, when I pulled in here, and I purposely came in late because I'll be honest with you, every black belt test, I'm always the first one here and usually the last one to leave. And these demos allow me to come in kind of later, and I really enjoy that. And when I came in, when I pulled in and saw all these cars, it just speaks volumes about what kind of person that Wesley is. And he's more than just an instructor here. He's more than just a leader. I think we all can, we have our stories, but you know, Wesley is just, he's just a solid human. And I think it just reminds us that no matter where we come from, no matter what we believe, or no matter where we've been through what we've been through in life, we all can learn from each other, and we all can grow from each other. And Wesley's the type of person that he just hasn't stopped growing since he's become a black belt. And it just seems like, I know you tested in 2021, it just seems like that was yesterday when we were right here, standing right up here, putting your belt on up here, and you had the same fans, the same people, just with adulation, just telling you how awesome you are. And I'll just tell you, because you're about to hear it from probably most of these people, that we just think you're awesome. So please come forward. We give Wesley a hand. just to talk a little bit more about Wesley as he finishes up hugging everybody and sharing some love for Molly Snowberger. Yes, Molly's traveling today. She's FaceTiming, I believe, and she's in a car somewhere on her travel. So we're glad you're here, Molly. She has a, if you didn't see, there's a camera set up with a phone with her, a little figurine of her right there. So it's pretty special. Wesley also is training Collie, and he tested the same night that I did, and when Grandmaster Hawkins was in from Australia, it was a pretty cool night, and I don't think I've ever seen Wesley that nervous in a long time, so it's really good. Tonight he looked perfectly calm in his element, which was a cool thing. So awesome. We'll do a group photo in just a little bit, but we do want you to interact with your fans. So real quick, before we go, just one thing. If you're sitting there and you're like, you're inspired in any way, let me just encourage you from one human to another, whatever your thing is, whatever you wanted to do, whatever it is, and it doesn't have to be martial arts, okay? I don't want to say that. What I'm saying is, if you ever wanted to learn a new language or go on a vacation to Rome, or if you ever wanted to learn how to play the banjo or whatever it is, you're sitting here. 11 years ago, his family decided, we want to try this new thing, whatever it is, and all of a sudden, 11 years later, we're all celebrating his individual accomplishments as an amazing human. So whatever it is that has been plaguing you, that's in your mind, man, I've always wanted to do that Spartan race, I've always wanted to do, whatever it is, go and do it. Do it today, okay? Your future self will thank you for it, and you will inspire so many other humans just like Wesley has today. So again, one more time, Sensei Wesley Blubaugh. Nice job.
Come back to it. I was just talking about him or somebody else, and I was like, you know, I'm gonna take away the option of you telling me no. So, and you're afraid that I'm around too.
Boom. All right, a couple of years, that'll be you.